I give you the longest reigning WWE champion in the last 10 years, John Bradshaw Layfield. I love you guys. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And what better place than the city of brotherly love itself to welcome home America's champion? Because I know that, quite frankly, none of your sports teams are champions. But today, you can live through me, your WWE champion. And quite frankly, sometimes I amaze even myself. This past Sunday at No Way Out, I made the impossible look routine yet again. I defeated the Big Show, that 500-pound sideshow freak, in the first ever barbed wire steel cage match. It is a miracle that I even survived, much less walked out of Pittsburgh as the WWE champion. And now I am here. I am here only for you, my loyal fans, the city that loves me, Philadelphia, in all of my glory. Because I, quite frankly, deserve this. I went through that razor sharp barbed wire. I took everything the Big Show had. I even got choke slammed so hard it broke the ring, but it didn't break the spirit, the indomitable spirit that makes me champion. Every time a critic says to me, JBL, you can't keep winning, I prove them wrong. I have guaranteed victory time and time again. My guarantees have never failed, so I guarantee you this. I simply cannot be beat. Dave Bautista, as great as he is, did not come to SmackDown because he knew that he could not beat me. But Dave, nothing personal, nobody can. I am a champion with class. I am a champion with dignity. I am a champion that likes to find things in life. Champagne, caviar, classical music, elegant, beautiful women. I am a champion that you people, quite honestly, could never be like, but you can always admire and say to your neighbor, I am so proud that JBL is our WWE champion. My opponent at WrestleMania, John Cena, does not have any of these qualities. I have more class than him inside the ring. I certainly have more class outside. It is not that he is not in my league. John Cena, you are nowhere near my league. In the 242 days of my record-breaking reign as WWE Champion, I have proven what I have always said, that I am a wrestling god. And John Cena, at WrestleMania, you will find out what it is like to bow at the feet of the greatest WWE champion of all time. But enough talk. Before these beautiful ice sculptures of my $1,000 cowboy hats start to melt, we got a party, and let's get this thing rolling.
The Big Show looks pretty up there.
Oh, my. Crashing the party hard, boy.
Dropping the guest in and across the table.
JBL's friends.
The Big Show. The Big Show is irate. The champion can't believe it. Here comes the cabinet. The Big Show, the man who, oh wow, a headbutt.
There goes the cabinet. There goes
the chief of staff, the champion, left alone in the ring. The Big Show is the man who chokeslammed the champion through the ring this past Sunday. And the Big Show is not through with JBL yet.
Oh my God.
And Basham from behind. Doug and Danny Basham, the co-secretaries of defense, perhaps saving the champion for the time being. The chief of staff with a champagne bottle across the back of the head, and the championship off the skull of the Big Show.
It looks like the champion is going to have his way with the Big Show.
Wow. The numbers game. And here comes the man JBL meets in WrestleMania. The number one contender, John Cena. Oh, takes out Jordan. A right hand to the champion. There go the Bashams. John Cena raising hell on Broad Street.
Supposed to be a party. Cole, what the hell is going on? No, no, no. Not the portrait.
Oh, no. The portrait into the skull of the champion.
My God.
In Philadelphia.
It's supposed to be a celebration. And a general manager's coming out here. Feel the pain that I'm trying to contain.
My heart is black. Hold on a minute, player. Hold on just a minute. Now, as long as I am general manager of SmackDown, I still make all the decisions around here. And tonight, this party ain't over, JBL. I'm going to continue this party tonight with tag team action. So JBL, you will team up with your chief of staff, Orlando Jordan, tonight. And the two men that you will face tonight, one of them will be the Big Show. And the other man will be none other than the United States champion, John Cena.
And that will land on John Cena battling back with a right hand. Again, showing guts and perseverance here. A right to the champion. Another right, and a clubbing blow to the back of the head, and a double team by Jordan and the champ. Cena fighting through a double team. The pounding ground attack, but now a knee to the gut.
The referee's got to get in here and do something.
And here's the Big Show who's going to do something. Clothesline to the champ and the chief of staff.
We've got to get some control here. Man, you know, a lot of emotions flowing throughout this ring, but
right to the ribs. It's going to be more emotions flowing throughout the ring. Oh, what a shoulder tackle!
Like a flying bus!
John Cena pumping it up and down! Jordan to his feet.
Look at this.
John Cena.
F-U.
And a few to Orlando Jordan.
This is what we do. You can see.
My knuckle shuffle.
Connecting to Jordan. Here's the cover by Cena. Hook of the leg and it's over. Cena in the big show.
This is basic.
Pick up the win.
JBL, not a happy champ by any means. Cena looked really good, as did Show.
John Cena and the Big Show have ruined the WWE Champion's night. John Cena and the Big Show have crashed JBL's party. As we take another look at what you call a flying bus.
Bam! Oh my God, what a collision there. I mean, Happy Beauty, and a five-number shuffle by Cena. And with the cockiness of Cena, gets the victory in a very impactful way.
John Cena was a party pooper tonight. But will John Cena spoil JBL's party April 3rd when they meet for the WWE title at WrestleMania?
That's how it's done, baby.
Yo. On the real, JBL's cabinet is boy. Oh, no, they claim that they want answers. They want answers. They want to know why John Cena put JBL through a platform at No Way Out. You know, like I was doing something wrong. They want to know why John Cena had to bust up JBL's party last week. Well, I'm going to tell them. Because I'm sick of it. I'm just like all of you. I am sick and tired of JBL. JBL this, JBL that. JBL want to drive out here with his limousine and throw a party for himself. Who the hell throws a party for themselves, man? JBL want to present himself with an award to tell you how great he is. You know, while JBL, he was born with a silver spoon in his mouth. Always had money, always had limos, always had stocks. You know, a few years ago, I spent my hard-earned money to sit right out there, and that's the truth. I ain't lying. I know what it's like to spend my money on tickets, to spend all day making my sign so I can hold it up and make some noise. I know what it's like to buy t-shirts, to buy that foam middle finger, to buy them old school WWE ice cream bars with Doink the Clown on the front. They're oh so milky going in, but they're oh so milky going out, so watch yourself, it's gonna be a long night. I busted up your party, JBL, because I want to fight. And you gotta realize that real recognizes real. These people don't care about your limos. Don't care about your stocks. They don't care about your cabinet. They wanna see a fight, baby. But JBL don't wanna fight. That's why JBL ducked me last week. So this week, the fighting champion is gonna take on Orlando Jordan. JBL's chief of staff. well, okay, we're going to do this tonight. And after I beat Orlando Jordan, JBL, I got an idea. You throw yourself another party. You roll out that red carpet, drive in your limousine down to the ring, make sure the champagne on ice, get your suit real nice, paint up another picture of yourself all I care, and present yourself an award for being the WWE's biggest JBL talk a lot about how long he been the champ. Well, you know something, homie? It ain't how many days you had that title. It's how many days you got till you lose that title. Because at WrestleMania, champion versus champion, I'm like the rest of y'all, man. I don't got no limo. We ain't got no stock. I ain't got no fancy suit. But at WrestleMania, we are going to have the WWE Championship. And that is real life, baby.
I would love a couple of answers. Because I do not understand why a guy like me, who already belongs in the Hall of Fame more than a guy like Hulk Hogan, the greatest WWE champion of them all, does not deserve a celebration. I do not understand how this very celebration was the cause for a couple of people who, quite frankly, can't be me to ruin my party. And I damn sure don't understand why you common people who so badly need a hero would cheer when my party was ruined. Like me, love me, hate me. You have absolutely no choice. I am your WWE champion. You must shut up and listen. You must respect me. Especially you, John Cena. Cena, you don't respect anything, do you? Look at you. Look how you dress. Look how you act. Look how you talk. Look what you did to the U.S. title. You have made a mockery of the U.S. title, and you have made a mockery of yourself. I'm not avoiding you, Cena. I despise you. I hate you for what you are. I hate you for what you stand. I hate the people who cheer you. And I simply do not want to be in the same room with you. And it makes me sick. It makes me sick that at WrestleMania, the grandest stage of them all, that will be etched in history, after all I have done as a champion, I have to step in the ring with a piece of garbage like John Cena. Cena, you brag. You brag about being from the stands. I brag about never being from the stands ever. You see, I don't pay to see you people. You people save your money, and you people pay to see me. There is a reason you sit there. There is a reason I am here. I am a wrestling god. Gods do not pay to see anybody. You said, Cena, that I was born with a silver spoon in my mouth. Well, I am proud. I am damn proud of my parents and that they were born with class and that they are still together. And I am damn proud that my kids will grow up with class and will go to a private school because they will not be influenced by you, Cena, or anybody else like you. You say you associate with these people. Let me tell you about these people. You are the scourge of America. Your daddies. Your daddies drink too much because your mamas are piece of trash who can't stay home. And since they can't stay together, you grow up in single parent homes. And instead of imitating me, these kids imitate you, Cena. They want to put a rhyme together. They want to put a ball in a hoop. And they hope to get out. All they find themselves is dead by age 30. And quite frankly, listen to me, I don't care. The thing I'm mad at is that when they die at such a young age, out of an overdose or whatever they're taking, people like me, have to take care of their families through handouts. Well, folks, I'm sorry. I can only have so many maids. I can only have so many gardeners. I can only have so many drivers. And I can only have so many doormen. Some of you people are gonna finally have to fend for yourself. You have no idea what's in this ring right now. And if you did, listen to me. You would not just cheer me, you would worship me. I am a once in a lifetime performer that you never ever get to see. I have transcended this genre. I am the most recognizable name on the face of this planet. And I demand, listen to me, listen to me. You people are too stupid. You are too stupid to realize greatness. You people are too stupid to chant my name. You two people are too stupid to realize what is here. You people are too stupid to give me respect. And I demand right now your respect. You're not listening. I am here because I want to be, not because I have to be. You people don't give me respect right now that I deserve. I will walk out of your armpit called Albany. I am the show. I'm not just the main event. And I'm telling you right now, you people better show me some respect or I will walk out now. You morons, get off your feet and applaud me. Remember the day, Albany. Remember the day you lost JBL.
John Cena's eyes tells the story, Cole. Hey, look at this. John Cena, power here. A spinning slam again.
And you sense the end may be near.
Pumping it up, man.
For the chief of staff.
Cena's pumping up, extra pumping here.
John Cena.
Look at this.
FU.
FU time.
He's got him set.
FU connecting. Hey, wait a minute. The Bashams.
I thought
the cabinet left.
Wait a minute.
There's an officer from the announce table.
The champion's right here in front of us.
See me.
JBL, nobody can see him except
John Cena has no clue.
Got enough fuel. Cena's gonna get enough fuel.
What is that thing you're carrying?
Why, JBL, I believe this is what John Cena used to call his United States Championship title.
Looks to me like some little bling bling sideshow, like a hubcap that these kids, instead of putting money in their education, put on their cars. That I find disgusting. That, for the time-honored tradition of sports entertainment, must be destroyed. The Bashams, the Secretaries of Defense, would you please do me a favor and get the trash can and the stairs, please? You people are about to understand why it is sometimes good for America that the rich keep the common down. That belt right there is everything I find reprehensible, everything I hate about John Cena. He has taken a time-honored tradition like the United States Championship, and he has made it into a sideshow freak ride. For that must be destroyed, just like in WrestleMania. John Cena will not only be destroyed, but he will bow at the feet of greatness. John Cena talks about street cred. I own the damn street. Just like your career, Cena. Up in smoke.
Oh, Jesus! You gotta be kidding me. Cena's championship was in there.
Orlando, that piece of trash was destroyed. I had something flown in from WWE headquarters, the WWE vault, worthy of you. Ladies and gentlemen, to a great American, to a man with class, something with class, the greatest athlete in SmackDown history, give it up for Orlando Jordan, your United States champion. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you your United States champion, Orlando Jordan, your future tag team champions, and the WWE heavyweight champion, John Bradshaw Layfield.
John Cena, JBL in his cabinet just destroyed.
I got some business to take care of. And I'm gonna take care of that business in the ring.
It's been brought to my attention that I have something in common with JBL. We both like to break things. It seems as if he likes to break titles. I like to break faces. JBL, you, Orlando Jordan, the Basham brothers, get your out here. We're going to handle this right now. Okay. You're probably in the back hiding behind those rent-a-cops you got. I tell you what. You leave him with the coffee and donuts, and you four, the cabinet, Orlando Jordan, JBL, come out here right now. We got some business. I know what it is. I know what it is. It's about the title, isn't it? Hey, I'll tell you what. Don't worry about the title. People just saw you destroy the United States title. And best believe, homie, at WrestleMania, I'm gonna get your shine. So it ain't about titles, it ain't about matches, it ain't about nothing but y'all getting your whipped right here, right now. Get out here.
Now, John, I know you're a little razzle-dazzle.
A little razzle-dazzled?
I know you're mad, player. So I tell you what I'm gonna do. Now, later on tonight, I had a WWE Tag Team Championship match with JBL and Orlando Jordan. But I say this, let's do this instead. How about right here tonight, Orlando Jordan, John Cena rematch for the United States Championship. You feeling that?
Slow your roll. You saw what they did to me last week on your show. And you saw them just destroy the United States title. This ain't about rematches, man. There's a code that I live by. Eye for an eye. They want to get in my business. I want to get in their business. Bring them all out right now.
Cena, I saw what JBL did last week. I get that. But listen, player, I cannot allow you to destroy my WrestleMania main event. Now, it's like I said, you have every right to avenge yourself. But player, you're gonna have to wait until WrestleMania. So I've got a job to do, John. Tonight, I'm gonna have to put my foot down, player.
You got a job to do.
Yeah.
You got a job to do, well, so do I. I gotta handle my business like a man. And you know what? If you're not going to bring them out, I guess then maybe you taking JBL's side, homie.
Just a minute, player. I'm not taking anybody's side. The thing is, John, I've got a job to do.
So let me get this right, player. After all this happened, you're going to tell me I can't get a crack at the four of them. They not coming out?
John, it's like I said, I'm sorry. I can't do that.
Well, player, that makes it easy. You see, I had to handle my business, but when it comes to this, you either part of the solution or you part of the problem. And since you ain't letting JBL come out, you part of the prop.
Oh, oh my! And it's you!
All right, we're gonna get all the gold.
That's right.
You hear me? I took this off of Eddie Guerrero. We are going to take the tag team championship off him and Rey Mysterio tonight. Tonight, the cabinet has all the gold.
That's right. Hey, what if John Cena shows up? We got that covered?
All you worried about is the tag team championships. You got it? These guys are here for that. You guys stay here, you watch the doors. You got that? I paid you for a reason. Secretaries of Defense, come with us, boys.
Oh, yeah. JBL and Orlando attempt to win all the gold next. Eddie Guerrero, the second official land for the cabinet. A heinous assault by the Bashams, JBL and Orlando Jordan. Mysterio, Guerrero have been rendered helpless here.
Oh, wow. Nasty kick to the mush by JBL. Eddie Guerrero is being held by one Basham. Mysterio's being held at the end of the ring by the other Basham.
This is an all-out street fight by the cabinet.
What the hell?
John Cena through the crowd.
He's been banned from the building. What the hell?
The neutralizer. That's still a pump in hand. John Cena going after the cabinet. Danny Basham takes
As GM of SmackDown, it is my duty and my obligation to present to each and every one of you the best in action and entertainment in television. But as your general manager, I will not allow John Cena or no other SmackDown superstar to lay their hands on me. I will not allow the inmates to run the asylum. And last week...
Hello, Mr. Long.
What do you want? What do you want? I'm addressing a SmackDown audience, man.
I know, this is my audience. They're my fans. They love me. I am their champion. And since I am their champion, they would want me here. At the moment that you come to the realization of what I have been telling you all along, that John Cena is a reprehensible piece of garbage. Teddy, he FU'd you last week. He could have permanently injured you. He took a weapon to me and to my entire cabinet. This guy in no way, shape, or form represents SmackDown. That's why I had to be here at the moment that you permanently suspend John Cena.
Well, JBL, I am not going to suspend John Cena. Why? And here's what it's gonna be, Clay. John Cena will not be able to lay a hand on you, JBL. And if he does, he will forfeit his WWE Championship match at WrestleMania. You feeling that?
Now you're talking. I like that, holla holla.
But, however, if you and John Cena are in a match together, bell to bell, then you're fair game, player.
I knew that. But if we're not in a match, not bell to bell, and if John Cena touches me, he loses his WrestleMania spot, right?
True that.
It's a wise decision, Teddy. Thank you.
JBL, there's one other thing. Tonight, right here in Savannah, Georgia, there's going to be a six-man tag team match. And it will be the Basham brothers, along with you, JBL. And your opponents will be the WWE Tag Team Champions, Rey Mysterio and Eddie Guerrero. And they will team up with John Cena. Now, how about that? You can't do that. Hey, you holler back, player.
JBL, champ, JBL.
What?
Are you that concerned about your match tonight? Your six man against John Cena, Eddie Guerrero, and Rey Mysterio? Look, I beat John Cena. If I beat John Cena, you imagine what you can do? Look, I'm the United States champion. You're the WWE champion. What?
That's my chief of staff. I am the WWE champion.
That's right, yeah.
And if John Cena touches me, any time outside of a match, bell to bell, he loses his match at WrestleMania, right?
Yes, he does.
I need a witness. Come on.
Now, let's go.
Not at all.
But there he is. You wait here. I need a witness.
No problem.
Johnny boy! How you doing? JBL, WWE champion.
You can call me champ. After you didn't want to meet me. You say you're a big wrestling fan. Are you a little in awe? Standing here in front of a wrestling god like me. What's up with the anger? Huh? You're the rapper, right? You know why I hate rap? I think it's a bunch of punk kids, a bunch of inner city illiterate kids singing about gangs and violence. That's something to really be proud of. Wanting to be me, don't you? You want to be me, don't you? You want to be rich. You want to be successful. You would love to be champion. You're not going to be. See, people like you don't make it to a level like me. People like you have your little families where your mama had to sleep with your landlord to pay your rent. Where your mama had to sleep with the grocery store man to pay your groceries. Where your mama just spent most of the time on her back. Bet you could hear it, couldn't you? Bet you could hear it every night. Bet you knew that. Bet you didn't know your daddy, did you? See, I knew Mike. He's rich. Still married, by the way. You got Basham Outlaws, don't you? You want to do something, don't you? Why don't you? Why don't you take the easy way out like your mama did and take a shot at me? Come on. You ain't got a chance at WrestleMania, and you know it, don't you? You know you don't have a shot. I'm going to embarrass you. You will worship at my feet. So why don't you take a shot at me? They say you can't touch me? Come on, coward. Oh, that's right. I just called you a stinking coward. Take a shot. Take a shot. Go ahead. Go ahead. Throw away WrestleMania. Be a man for once. Stand up for something. Come on! Do it! You know what? You as stupid as you look. I ain't gonna hit you. Now. Because in 5 minutes, that bell's gonna ring. And when it does, I am going to beat your ass. Thanks for the motivation, partner.
Mysterio trying desperately to make it to the corner, to make a tag here.
It's close, Cole. Can he power back the Basham?
Just a hand length away. Eddie doing it, going after Orlando Jordan.
Eddie's doing the right thing.
And look at John Cena exploding in the ring.
Yeah, that, but there's no tag. John Cena's not legal here.
Uh-oh. Look at FU.
The FU.
And look at JBL. JBL with the cross the ring. Big back body drop.
Are we good, Cole?
John Cena knocking the champion out of the ring. And Cena is on the attack here.
Big time flying shoulder block.
And Cena reversed. Shoulder first into the steel steps. And look at Mysterio taking out the champion.
Rey Mysterio's the legal man here. Latino Heat got Doug Basham.
The three amigos perhaps on the way.
Look at how quick this here. Look at that. Here's a third one. Watch those hips. Bam!
Eddie Guerrero, Latino Heat, knocking the chief of staff off the apron. Look at Rey Mysterio dropping the nine. He is the legal man.
Got him, Cole.
The Basham up in the ring.
Wow.
It's over.
Wow.
Eddie, Rey, Cena, pick up the win.
Here are your winners, Eddie Guerrero, Rey Mysterio, and John Cena.
And JBL missed with a steel chair. To John Cena.
Well, the match is over.
And Cena's got a steel chair.
The bell rang. The match is over. Cena don't do it.
Cena's going to blow his WrestleMania title.
Cena don't do it. Cena, no.
Cena's going to blow his WrestleMania chance.
He's impressed with Scotty. There's a size difference, yeah.
What does that have to do with anything? Oh, come on now. The champion's not even involved in this matchup. Total disrespect for Scotty Too Hotty. And now a pie face. And that's your champion. Here's your champion, Dan.
He's the WWE fans champion. Now I'm proud to say JBL is
a look at the tip to the side of the head. And went to Orlando Jordan. Scotty just took the WWE champion off his feet. And there's a bulldog. And Scotty. shouldn't have stuck his nose where it didn't belong here.
How did he stick his nose, Cole? What did he do? He slapped the guy in the face with his cowboy hat. So what?
For no reason.
Uh-oh, what?
I got this. Stay there.
I got this. I just heard JBL say, I got this.
Well, the champion telling Orlando, I've got this. And the champion back in the ring.
Whoa.
And a kick to the midsection of Scotty. And a clubbing blow to the back of the head. The bell rang. I guess this is an official matchup.
Well, I'll tell you what.
Caught in midair is Scotty.
Oh, my God.
Fallaway slam by the champion, JBL. And now dropping the elbow into the sternum.
I'll tell you, Cole, I got a hand to the champion, JBL. He's in his street clothes. I mean, cowboy boots, you know. Come on, he's in there with a competitor like Scotty and just an unscheduled match. That just shows what the WWE champ has made of. He's a great competitor.
The champion all fired up after being embarrassed by Scotty Too Hotty and the Worm. And here's the reversal. Champ whipped into the corner. Uh-oh, look out!
Watch out!
Clothesline from the hole! Exploding! Hook of the leg! JBL picks up the victory!
Here's your winner, the WWE Champion,
JBL! Well, you can bet John Cena's watching this. Tell you what, that clothesline from hell was nothing but impact.
If JBL hits the clothesline from hell in 10 days at WrestleMania, he will continue his history-making reign as WWE Champion. There's absolutely no doubt about that.
Look at that determined look on JBL. The eyes tells the story, Cole, I'm telling you.
You're a punk criminal!
I see a limo that says JBL sucks. JBL sucks. Dude, JBL is you. You drove out here in a limo that says JBL sucks.
That's what a $200,000 car.
You know. You know, between that limo fiasco and this hostile crowd here in Memphis, if I was you, I'd just do something about that.
You better show me some respect. You
gonna hit me?
JBL.
You gonna hit me? You gonna do something? Come on, throw a punch.
Hey,
throw a punch here, Big Daddy, come on.
You can do something if you want to.
I'm ready for the next question.
Well, then let's move on.
JBL's holding his cool.
How important is one's social and economic upbringing in being a champion?
Apparently it's real damn important. Look at what that criminal just did to my car. You see, there's a reason that punk criminals like him, the only way he makes it in a car is if you drive me. There's a reason that people like you are kept down by the rich, because that's what's better for America. You mock what you don't understand, and flat honestly, you're jealous, because the only way you know you'll have money like me is if you win the lottery or you turn to crime. So I tell you what, at WrestleMania, I'm gonna turn to crime too. I'm gonna rob you of your dreams. I'm gonna rob you of your hopes. And I'm gonna rob you of your dignity when I make you, Cena, bow down and worship at the feet of a wrestling god.
John Cena, you're up, player.
Sounds like somebody crapped in your Cheerios this morning, homie. But, you got a point. I mean, this whole economic thing, maybe I just lost my head. I guess what you're trying to say is I got no respect for, you know, the championship.
You got no class!
I got no class. I mean, look at how I'm dressed. I guess. I mean, I think I'm doing all right. Are we good or what? Don't get your panties in a bunch. There are some people who think that we should act a certain way, that we should dress a certain way. So I'm a man of peace. I mean, we can probably solve all this if I just wore a suit and tie, right?
You would look a lot better in a tie. Right now, you look like a piece of crap.
Well, let me see. I'd look better in a tie. Let's just see if that works.
Hey, 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 Teddy, Teddy, you can't touch me. You, WrestleMania, you look.
Oh, no.
So a tie would look better, huh? Oh no, I feel like a banker in this. This still sucks. Oh, but oh, dog. That was yours. And after the car thing, whew, and the tie, you're probably pretty mad right now, huh? You probably wanna do something, don't you? Maybe throw a punch, maybe hit me. If I hit you, I can't go to WrestleMania, but then again, I'm not the one looking like a total jerk, so maybe, you know, maybe you want to do something about it. Maybe you want to throw a punch.
No, I'm not playing your games. You do not outthink the master. At WrestleMania, you will have all you want. But until then, son, play your stupid games.
John Cena, the next question is for you. Now, I want to ask you this, player. What do you need?
What do I need to do to get this punk over here to swing at me? Well, now that's an important question. And one I think we need to address. What if, right here, right now, I prove the wrestling god, the champion of champions, a man of class, JBL, to be nothing but a liar?
I don't lie.
Hey, have faith in your boy. I can pull it off. Now, Monsignor Theodore Long, watch closely, because I'm not going to touch you, dog.
You better not touch.
But I am going to touch your 10-gallon hat. Oh, no, this is nice, dude. This ain't exactly my style or nothing, but I mean, you can tell the craftsmanship. Everything is there. Is this Gucci?
It's $1,000 Stetson.
Okay, then we know that this is probably a 10-gallon hat, right?
I hate you. I hate you.
I'll take that as a yes, 10-gallon hat. Well, let's do something. Let's see how many gallons this hat's gonna hold.
Oh no.
Oh, no.
It's $1,000 hat!
Oh my God.
He's not touching you.
Dude, that ain't even close to like 1 gallon. That means your is a liar. Oh yeah, by the way, I'm done with the hat. You can have it. Oh no! Look at you, man. Looks like you done had an accident all over yourself. They make diapers for that sort of stuff. I mean, you got problems, we'll help you. Oh, look at you.
I'm gonna kick your ass at WrestleMania.
Show me what you gonna do at WrestleMania.
At WrestleMania!
Then show me what you gonna do at WrestleMania. Come on, right here. You throw a punch and I swear I will knock the hell out of you. You ain't gonna do nothing, are you? Just like I thought. But I bet you stand there thinking that you're clever for not playing my games. You look ridiculous. And as clever as you think you are, well, I think you're something else.
Now what?
I'm not touching you. I'm not touching you.
Oh my God.
This is ridiculous.
You gun! You piece of garbage. You want me?
You know what?
You want me?
You know what? See, in the world that I come from, in the world that we come from, there's people who talk about it, and then there's people who be about it. WrestleMania 21. Let me give you a little preview of what's going to happen to you.
The FU symbol.
Please hit an FU on JBL.
Well, John Cena called out JBL tonight, and the WWE champion didn't want to go.
No, 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 Cole. JBL's a smart champion. JBL is picking his spots, and his spot is 10 days at WrestleMania. Mark my words, Cole. Cena may have punked out the champ tonight, but at WrestleMania, JBL is going to bring the fight to John Cena. I'm telling you.
Look what happened last week after the debate. You lost control, player.
No, you have no idea how close I came to losing control. And what would have happened? You would have lost your main event at WrestleMania, Teddy. Because if I would have lost control and I would have jumped on John Cena, there would have been nothing, come hell nor high water, that would have stopped me from destroying him like I will do at WrestleMania. I would have broke his jaw, I would have broke his back, I would have broke his neck, but he would not have made it to WrestleMania. Now think about that.
Yeah, you think about this. You busting up in here with all this conversation. Now how about letting me know where you're coming from, dawg?
I'll tell you where I'm coming from. You have been trying to take this championship off me since the day that I won it. You have no idea who I am, that I am indeed a wrestling god. You almost robbed me, along with the SmackDown fans, of the gratification of seeing John Cena worship at my feet. Listen to this. I guarantee you this. You think you've had enough of me? You're wrong. Because I guarantee you. I guarantee John Cena. And I guarantee the entire world that at WrestleMania, I will do as I always do. I will walk out as the WWE champion.
You guarantee that, huh?
Yeah. You think you've gotten the better of me? You got another thing coming, playa.
It's Looney to coast the ring with a shoulder tackle.
I'm telling you, JBL can't be liking this. What's next, Cole? The FU thing that he does?
I'd love to see it, because Cena's pumping
there
it out.
There he is. There.
Wait a minute.
He is. Officers, that right there, that right there is the man who vandalized my limousine. They have a warrant for your arrest, John Cena. You may be a common street thug. They have a warrant for your arrest. You're going to jail. You're going to jail like you've never been there before. Handcuff him. I suggest you use a nightstick on him. He's a common piece of garbage. Mason, if you have to, arrest him, throw him below the jail.
What the hell goes on here on SmackDown, Michael?
What's the matter, Cena? All too familiar for you. You're going to jail, pal. You shouldn't have vandalized my car.
Can't believe this.
Get used to this. Get used to humiliation. I know you will post bail, but I know this. At WrestleMania, look at me, boy. At WrestleMania, it will be a lot more humiliating when you are forced to worship at the feet of a wrestling god. What do you think about that, Johnny? Huh? WrestleMania. WrestleMania.
JBL touched him. JBL touched him.
Cena's attacking JBL.
No, he isn't.
Arrest him. Arrest him. Hey. Nothing.
I will fight you. Come on.
You're going to jail.
Come on, a cheap shot.
Self-defense. That was self-defense.
That's right. Cena resisted arrest. Sad when
Cena
JBL has to do the cop's job.
Let me tell you in a language you would understand. You can't see me. Get used to worshiping at my feet. I am indeed a wrestling god. See you in 3 days, punk. Wow.
Sunday at WrestleMania, will JBL's historic reign continue, or will the championship finally change hands? Is the time now for John Cena Sunday? Or will that man, JBL, continue to be champion?
Well, I want to say this, that JBL is a smart man. And you know, Hollywood is all about spectacles, but they've never seen a spectacle like this Sunday's WrestleMania.